Hi, and welcome back to Gourmet Glyn's Country Kitchen, GG for short. Now today, we are going to be doing, well, I've got a bit of a dry throat, let's have a quick cup of tea while I'm here. We're making potato scones. So we've made some mashed potato from the Duchess recipe that we did earlier. You might have seen a couple of weeks ago. And then today, you're going to put 4 ounces of self-raising flour. Then put a half a teaspoonful of dried mustard into the flour mix. Got some mashed potato we've made earlier. Got some milk, some butter. All these are going to go in together. So I'm going to put a couple of ounces of butter into the flour mix. And rub that together so it becomes all crumbly. And then we're going to add this to the mashed potato. At the same time, I've got a very thick bottomed frying pan on the stove with some oil in there. Getting ready for, and as you can see, I've done some grated cheese. I meant to put this on a plate and I forgot. So there you go, we've got it in a plastic bag. Back there it goes. So we've got some cheese into our mashed potato. And give it all a mix up. Those potatoes. Another thing, if you have some potatoes left over, if you have some mashed potato left over, another good way of using it is doing half fat to flour when you make your pastry and adding the mash to the pastry. So you go mash pastry. So you can do like a quiche, you can use a nice pastry. Be a nice potato pastry for your quiche. So we'll put some milk in there. So it's going to look a bit like this. I think it's quite firm, like a dough when you're making a dough. And what we're going to do, we're going to go over to the stove now. And I've got this pan on over here. We're going to get it quite hot. We need it really quite hot, we do. I make them into little, you know, if you're making scones. So little patties, maybe they call them. I'm going to put them into there. See how they come out. Nice and golden brown. So if you do them too thick, they're going to take just too long to cook through. So I'm going to cook about 4 of these at a time. There will be some over still, so you'll be able to, but just so we can show you what's going on, I'm going to cook 4 now. And we're going to do a poached egg on top of these, because this is a fantastic breakfast or a high tea maybe, when you're getting leftover mash, bit of flour, butter, milk, and there's salt and pepper in the mixture as well, which I never told you about that I put in beforehand. I've got to wash my hands now. So you do get sticky fingers, nothing you can do about that. I've got to wash my hands, otherwise I won't be able to pick anything back up again. We've got the water on for poached egg. I'm going to put an egg in there now. Give it a spin and you get like a whirlpool. And if you pour that into the whirlpool, that should stay together. There you go, it's starting to brown. Not quite enough really, to be perfectly honest with you, so we're going to put them back again there. Put it up a little bit higher. And while we've got this cooking, I also would also always like to thank my family and my friends for all their support and my lovely country kitchen. There we go. Okay, this is very, very hot. Very hot. You mostly could just make just mash, but we're doing it as a scone. So the scones is a flour, a butter. If you're doing a lot of them, you could just pop them in the bottom of the oven. If you've got the oven on, just to keep them warm through. If you've got, say, 5 or 6 you're having breakfast, then you might actually only want to give one person one. Otherwise, for me, I'm having two with a Post-it. Gotta get a holy spoon. Check what our egg's doing. You might like some bacon. Some nice bit of bacon with it. Egg, fried egg, or poached egg, scrambled egg. Well, they're coming on really good now. So if you keep them on there a bit longer, to try and work out this. The gas has gone out now. Oh, I love live TV. Quickly. Oh. There we go. Gassing myself now. That's lovely. Let's get the plate set up. I'm going to keep them turning. Take a couple of minutes each side. I'm using actually bantam eggs today. I've got some lovely bantam eggs got hold of. Once again, I have been to the local farm shop to get my ingredients again for some of the dishes we're going to be showing for the next couple of weeks. Just going to double make sure they're all cooked both sides, as they are. Of course, you've got the cheese as well in there. A nice strong cheese, so look, both sides. So they're nice and golden brown. We've got that. I'm going to put those back over the back there because all I'm going to do is show you a few already done. We've got a nice, we must put a knob of butter on there. Butter on both of them so it seeps through. Poached egg. Poached egg on the top. Butter starts to melt. And I think because we're showing you a picture what the finished product looks like, put a little bit of parsley on there. And for me, a bit of pepper. One potato scone with a poached egg, and I'll see you next time on Gourmet Glenn's Country Kitchen.